Hi, Stacy.
Hi.
Stacy Francis. I'm a singer. I've worked on Broadway, in the West End, the musical theater. I've recorded records, and some of you might know me as a finalist from The X Factor. So I've worked on stage for most of my career. Today I wanted to come and do a video and start maybe a little video series, actually, about the psychology of singing and maybe giving some tips to some of you on vocals and how to get through standing on the stage in front of tons of people without being afraid. And I just first thing that I really wanted to talk about. I've gone on YouTube and I've watched a lot of instructors talk about vocal lessons and how to sing and the structure of a voice and the body and the importance of how to breathe and those sorts of things. But I've really never found a video on the psychology of singing and what that means. What I found with a lot of young singers that I work with is that they get really, really nervous and they really feel timid and they feel afraid. And to me, that's the first barrier to actually standing on stage. Before you actually sing a song, are you afraid of the audience? Are you afraid of what people might think about you, them judging you, how they feel about how you sound, all of those things? I mean, obviously, I stood on the biggest stage in the world in front of Simon Cowell, and to be able to stand there and be critiqued and judged is a very hard thing as a singer.
Let me tell you something, Stacey. I've done this a long, long time. That was one of the best auditions I have ever heard in my life. You did more than sing it. You believed in it, loved it, loved it, loved it.
And when you're in the middle of a song, the last thing you want to do is feel, okay, do these people like me? Am I doing okay? I mean, and that monologue in your head while you're actually trying to sing a song, to have that kind of dialogue is really, really distracting. So I really wanted to talk to you today about some of the things that you could do while you're standing on stage, or some of the things that could help you actually confront and attack that fear. Because what I found is, for myself, even growing up, I grew up in the Baptist church, and I had the opportunity to sing in the choir, and I had the opportunity to grab the microphone at a very, very, very young age, at infant stage, when most people really don't have that opportunity. Like, I look at my daughter right now, she's 8 years old, and she has sang in choirs, and she does this, but because my uncle was a pastor, and I was sort of deemed a preacher's kid, I had the ability to go up in front of the audience and grab a microphone at a very young age. I remember singing as young as 4 years old in front of the audience. And I didn't know it then, but that was actually getting me ready to prepare for the stage. And it actually helped me get rid of stage fright. And I didn't even understand that that component was happening. Stage fright is a very serious thing. It stops you. And when you start to think about what other people think about you, it can really, really distract you. And it can really not only distract you, but it can stop you from having a very successful career in the industry. I feel like a part of me went through that. Like, I felt so much about, I don't know if I can sing. Am I singing off key? Am I okay? And what does this person think about me? So much that sometimes I didn't think I was a great singer, or I didn't think that I could sing because I was so afraid of what others thought. So I want to help you. I want to give you some tools on the importance of this. Okay, so sometimes when you're on stage, you think there's like all these flows of communication going on, right? So you're communicating to the audience, okay? The audience is communicating to you. There's a point when maybe an audience member is communicating to another audience member. And there's a point when you're communicating to yourself. There's a point when maybe the guy walks out to go to the toilet and you think, oh, he just went to the bathroom. Or you think, oh, maybe he didn't go to the bathroom. Maybe he left because he hates my voice. Oh my God, I suck. You know, so all of these things can actually stop you from delivering a song in a way that you want to deliver the song to the audience. So this series that I want to do is I want to go over the importance of understanding every word you sing in a song. I want to go over the importance of knowing, learning a song like you would learn a monologue as an actor and actually delivering that monologue in music. I want to go over the importance of not getting so caught up in what others think that you can actually deliver the song in present time without getting distracted with, oh, am I okay? Did I hit the note right? What am I gonna do next? What note can I sing next? And if I do this, am I gonna sing it off key? Is it gonna be the right run? Like all of these things that we need to handle before you walk on the stage. These are things that I wanna do in this next video series. And I want you to tune in. The first tip that I wanna give you is if you are a singer and or you feel that you can sing and you have stage fright, I want you to honor yourself. That's the first thing. I want you to decide, I am a singer. This is the first thing. Before I do any other video, before I go any other way and teaching you anything, your decision has to be, I am a singer. Now, I've been able to work with some of the greatest artists on the planet. I remember going in the recording studio with Prince and feeling, obviously, it's Prince. You feel like, oh my God, this is, oh my God. But what if I was too afraid? What if I didn't believe in myself enough to make that journey? Okay, I sang on stage with Chaka Khan. I remember being on stage with her and I was the lead in a show that she was the lead in as well. And she had to give me the microphone and I had to imitate every riff she did. Now, what if I was too afraid to do that? And then I sang background for Aretha Franklin. And I sang background for Madonna. But everything starts with a decision, right? So if you feel like, oh, I'm too afraid, think about how much you're stopping, not only stopping yourself, but you're stopping the world from an opportunity to hear a great singer or a great artist or really create something phenomenal. I really want to help you through that. I think that you might sound very, very simple when I say this first video is just about you deciding. But it is. Because if you don't make the decision, if you feel doubt or, I mean, I had somebody inbox me last week who said to me, can you tell me what you think about my voice? And I was like, okay, sure. She sent me a video. She wouldn't video herself. It was literally a video of the ceiling. And I heard her background singing in the background. And I was like, wow, this girl has a really great voice. I said, you sound really amazing. She was like 20 years old. She says to me, you're the only person I've ever sang for. What? You're 20 years old and you send a video to a stranger and I'm the only person you ever sang for? Like, think about what she's doing to herself as an individual, the sabotage that she's doing to herself and to her own mind, just that she's like sitting over there with this phenomenal talent, afraid to share it with the world because she's so afraid to be judged. And I'm telling you, like on so many levels, that's so sad. It's sad because we live in such a harsh world that people are so full of judgment and we live in such a angry social media world where people are so mean, but then there's also really loving people who will flow you power and love and say, you know what, you're amazing, I love you, and keep singing and keep going and don't stop. So again, this first video is, I want you to decide, I am a singer. And once you decide that, I want you to follow the rest of my videos. I want you to put in the comments below questions that you have for me that I can help you so that we can help you grow your dream, okay? I wanna help you make your dreams come true. I wanna help you be great, okay? And so you can watch some of my videos. You can go to my website. You can see who I am on YouTube. Put in Stacy Francis Purple Rain because people really love that one. And let me know, you know, what you think about that. And then come back to me and ask me for any help you need in this area, and I would love to help you. Okay? Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to comment. See you soon.